The topic is threaded binary tree. What is mean by threaded binary tree? You know what is binary tree? What is binary tree? It is a tree which has a restriction that for any node you should have at most two branches. That is the binary tree, right? So for any node you have at most two branches. If more than one branch, more than two branches are there, then it is simply a tree. If there is a restriction in the links, that is the number of links or number of connections from one node to another node, then it is going to be a special tree. If that restriction number of edges coming out of the node is 2, then it is a binary tree. So here, this is the best example for binary tree. And of course, you remember our very first presentation. That is, there are two ways of representing the tree in the computer memory. One is by means of array, that is linear representation. Another one is by means of pointer, that is linked representation. So when I say the advantages and disadvantages of both the linear as well as the linked representation, in linear representation, wastage of memory is there due to many unused memory location. Because of many unused memory location, many space is wasted. When you take the case of linked representation, here also wastage of memory is there because of null pointers. So what is suggested by these two people is A.J. Perls and Thornton is they want to utilize that null pointers. So the memory that is allotted for the null pointers should be used effectively by using the concept of threads. So if you use the thread in the place of null pointers, so you should not confuse with the normal pointer as well as the thread. So thread also looks like a pointer, but it is not actually a pointer. It is just a connection that arises from the null pointer, that is a null location to point it to a specific node in the previous layer. So that is what especially in the memory. So what is the use, sir? Because using the thread pointer, we can easily backtrack and you can easily search back. When you reach the null location, if you want to come back, then you may use the thread in order to come back or in order to visit the already traversed node, like that of stuff. So let me explain this with the help of furthermore example. So there are many null pointers. So the idea is to use the null pointers effectively by using the concept of thread. There are two ways of threading. One is one-way threading, another one is two-way threading. In order to establish a thread, say for example, if you go for a linear linked representation, a node in a tree, see if it is the node A and it has a child B and right child is C. So what it is, that is divided into three compartments. A here, right? This is left pointer, LPTR, and this is right pointer, RPTR, right pointer, and this is having the node like this, B here, right, and C here, right, so this is, so this may be a null pointer because the tree is only containing three nodes, so these are null pointers. So in order to effectively use this null pointer, that is the right child pointer, left child pointer, middle you have a data, say for example B means. So you have a left threaded tag and a right threaded tag. In case if this is null, then this memory is utilized by this thread. Then this memory is utilized by thread. Otherwise, no need for a memory pointer, right? So there are two ways of threading, I said, one-way threading and two-way threading. In one-way threading, a thread will appear in the right field, only in the right field. So that means even if it is left pointer is null, we are not bothering about the left pointer, we are focusing only on the right field, that is a right pointer. So if the right pointer of any node is null, then that pointer will create a thread, and thread will lead to the node in the previous level by following the inner traversal. by following the inner traversal. Let me explain this with the example. So for example, this is a representation. You should not confuse with that. Like this, you imagine or you assume some left and right child pointers are there. Left and right child pointers are there, like this, right? Like this, you have left and right, 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 right? So in case, so here this left is connected with the J, this left is connected with the L. And this is having one left pointer and this is having one, right pointer and a left pointer. So we are not bothering about this left pointer. And we are taking your arrow. See, this is an arrow. These arrows are treated as a thread. These arrows are treated as thread. So wherever you find this arrow is treated. So this arrow follows your inner traversal. So what is inner traversal? So if you take the inner traversal for this tree, what is the inner traversal? What is the formula or what is the shortcut idea in order for establishing the inner traversal? Let me take what is the formula? L left root right, right? So you are coming, this is the root node, you should not process it, you should come to the left. This is again a parent node, it has one more left node, so you come here, so you process this left node, so D comes first. So after left, what is that? D, that means root. So you have to print B. After printing B, you have to print the E. While you are printing E, you are finding that E has one left child. So F you have to print, and then E you have to print, and then E you have to print. And after this is over, then you go for A. So you are printing the A. You are printing the A. Then what you print? So this full side is over, then you go for right side. Right side. C. If you come to C has one left child, G. So G is printed. Then C. So like that, the inner traversal goes on. You know it very well. So when you go for threading, the right pointer of the null pointer. See, this is null pointer. So for A node, both the left pointer, right pointer is pointing to A node. Left pointer is pointing to B node, and right pointer is pointing to A node C. Likewise, for a B node, the left pointer is pointing to D, but right pointer is right pointer is pointing to E. When you take the left pointer, right pointer of D, see this pointer, sorry, let me take some other color so that I can designate it well. Yeah, I can take this one. Yeah, yes. See, the left pointer is null and the right pointer is also null. Since it is one-way threading, you have to take only the null pointer. You have to consume only, see all the cases, the right pointer is taken. Right pointer is considered. The right pointer is considered. So you have to consider only the right pointer. You have to consider only the right pointer. And that right pointer is created a thread. And that thread is attached to. And that thread is, see, attached to some other node. What is that node? That node is the one that follows the inner traversal. See, D is the node. The D's right pointer is null. So the null pointer is created as a thread and is attached to B. B is a node which has both the left and null pointer is complete. F is a node which has left pointer null as well as right pointer null. So we are not bothering about left pointer, right pointer. So right pointer should is null. So in order to create a thread, the right pointer null address is utilized by a thread, and the thread is pointing to E. So likewise, you should go on. See, if you take all the threads, the threads right pointer, the threads emerges from right pointer, and that right pointer will point to the adjacent node in the inner traversal of the tree. So that's the one-way threaded binary tree. In case of two-way binary thread tree, both the left and right pointer have been utilized. There also you have to follow the inner traversal. Say for example, if B is a node, and if B has both left as well as right pointer as null. Let us assume B is a node, both left pointer as well as right pointer is null. Then left pointer is arises to a thread and it is pointing to node D. Right pointer is gives rise to a thread and it is pointing to node F. So this is what the idea here. This is what the idea here. So you should follow this principle in order for two-way threading. So two-way threading, listen to it, two-way threading. See, F is two pointers. So these two pointers are null. These two pointers are null. So you have to utilize these two null pointers in an effective way by creating a thread. So you have to emerge a thread both in the left side as well as in the right side. So the left side thread is emerged. So when you look at the inner traversal, so left side should be left side thread should have a connection to F. Right side thread should have a connection to A. So that is the idea. So that right side connection to A will be E to A, E. Right. So that is the idea here. So left side already is having. So yeah, if we have to take F, right? So F, if you take F, you take F, F, where is the F? F, left side is B and right side is, left side is B. See, this node is B, it's going, and right side is going to E. So that is the way in which you have to create a two-way thread. So again, it is inner traversal, but you should consider both the left and right pointer. So the scenario is, either you are considering only the right pointer in case that is one-way threading, or you are considering both right and the left pointer, that is in case of two-way threading. So sometimes you go with threaded with the header node. So that is simply a header node is the initiator node which conveys the metadata about the tree. That is the where is your root node originates. Is there any null pointer associated with the leaf node? If that null pointer is doesn't backtrack with the corresponding node in the inner traversal, then you should connect to the header. So that is the idea of a gridding, the header node. So in general, the header node will be a node which doesn't have any data, but which will be acting as a node, as the initiator node to proceed with the further operation that deals with the data tree. So one of the advantages and the disadvantages is, see, if you have thread, then the traversal operation is still more faster. See, you should not come back and you should not rotate back when you are going for a traversal operation. Directly with the help of the thread, you can go back by following the inner thread. So the traversal operation is more faster. But when you take the case of insertion and deletion, it is somewhat time consuming, but it is very easier. So time consuming, if you take it as a disadvantage, but easy to implement, you can take it as an advantage. And another thing is, you need additional bit. What additional bit you need? See, here it is mentioned that if L thread equal to 1, if it is 1 means, what is that? That will indicate that left pointer is a thread pointer. So it is a null pointer and it is connected to a thread. If it is zero means that left pointer is an actual pointer. So you need an additional bit information you need to store. That is also needed. What is the second advantage? Is we can efficiently remove the predecessor. Yes, of course. We can remove it. If we are in the node, its immediate predecessor, that is the node in the previous layer, can be easily tracked because of the inner traversal, because of the thread. So that is the advantages and disadvantages of the threaded binary. That's all about threaded binary tree. And one more important tree we are going to see in this class is heap. So what is heap? So heap is a kind of complete binary tree that can be used to serve as a purpose of some other special kind of data structure like priority queue that you will see or you will study in the next semester. But right now, we are going to see is what is heap, how to create a heap, what are the two types of heap, how to insert, delete, and elements in a heap, what are the two properties of a heap, structure property as well as order property, how to maintain the two properties of heap while constructing the heap. That's what we are going to see. So before that, root node is the node which is sits at the top of any tree. And when you are going to build a tree, even if it is a binary tree or any other tree, the best practice is to attach the node from left to right. Say, for example, once you form the root node, the immediate node after the root node that you have to form is the left child of the root, then followed by right child, then followed by left child of the left child of the root node, then right child. So likewise, all the nodes are attached in the left side direction to the right direction. And you have to fill the values. If you look at the values of the heap, see, what is the number in the top? 45. Left side, what is there? 35. Right side, what is there? 23. So do you think that it is the property of binary search tree? Definitely not. If it is a binary search tree, what you will see? Left side, lesser value. Right side, you will find a greater value. Right? But here, both the values are lesser. And if you keep on going, so this in this side, left side 27, right side 27. Here again, both the values are lesser when compared with the parent node. So to left side 22 and the right side 4. Again, it is lesser. Lesser level. So what you have observed is, see, this is level 0, this is level 1, this is level 2, and this is level 2. Level 3. So in the 0th level, that is at the root level, the value is very higher. When you are coming to the next level, the value is lower. Another level, that value is still lower. So it is a, even though if you view your tree as a layered structure in one way, if that layered structure is used in a way that it has to fulfill the data elements in such a way that the top node will have a higher value followed by the lower level accordingly, if it goes, means so what else you can see, that is a heap. This is a heap. Of course, this kind of heap is a max heap. Why it is called a max heap? Because the root element is having the maximum element. Accordingly, when you come down layer by layer, the number of the quantity of the value of the number is reduced upon coming down from layer by layer. So that is the max heap. In case of minimum heap, what is that? The root element is having the lesser element. The next element is a little higher. The next layer having elements a little higher than that. The next layer is having the elements a little higher than that. So likewise, the number value of the elements is keep on increasing when you just move forward. So that is the idea here. So adding a node to the heap, adding it. So when you are going to add a node, how to add a node to the heap? So I in the initial slide itself, it is so that whenever you want to insert a node, the node should be inserted in the left to right fashion. Suppose if it is the given tree, see, this is the given tree. So in this given tree, if you want to add 42, you simply add the node in the left to right direction. So this layer level is filled. This level is filled. This level is filled. This level you have slots. So what order you have to follow from left to right order? Left side, this node is there. So next level, you have to fill the 42, right? So after filling this 42, what you have to do is you should push the node upward by one position. So you should compare the node in that level to the another node in the previous level. By comparing the value, if it is the max key, if the given data element to be inserted is a maximum element, then you should swap it to one more layer. That is, from the bottom layer to it, swap it to the third layer, like that, the swapping will go. So when I compare after inserting the 47, I have to compare the 42, when I have to compare the value 42 that is in the layer level 0, 1, 2, 3, the third level should be compared with the node in the second level. That is an indirect connection. So that is, you have to compare 27 with 42. Which is greater? 42 is greater, then you should do a swap. So 42 swap is done. Then you have to compare the 42 with 35. So your swap is done. Then you have to compare 42 with 45. No need to swap. So you have to left assist. So this is what a node is added into the heap, right? So when you are doing this thing, this kind of task is called reheapification. That is, you are maintaining the heap property. What is the heap property? That structure property is left to right. The node should be arranged, node should be attached, and the node should be created, and node should be inserted. And you always maintain the order property. That is, the root element should have the maximum element. It has a maximum heap, and other layer should have the minimum element compared with one another. So when you are inserting a node, as per the structure property, you are inserting a node from left to right, that is at the loss level. And then you are making a reheapification operation by means of simple swap after comparing the values of that level with the node in the previous level. Accordingly, you move the value to one layer upward until the root level. So this is what the reheapification upward process while adding a node. Likewise, when you are going to remove an element, say for example, I want to remove element, that also you should come from the right to left. So first you should remove 27, then you should remove 19, then you should remove 4, then you should remove 22. So likewise, you should come in this direction when you are going to remove an element. When you are going to add, you are going in this direction. So this arrow is for add. and this is for delete. So now if you want to delete 27, what you have to do is you simply swap 27 in the place of 45. So you remove the 45 here. Swapping is a larger cell until the new node reaches the acceptable length. So this kind of process. So again, what you have to do after removing that element? So you have to swap it, and you have to find the position in the corresponding position. So now the root element has been deleted, and you have followed the process of finding the suitable location for 27. So 27 is coming down. So this process is called reheapification downward. So what you are doing it? So when you are going to delete an element, so what is that? So you are deleting the root element. While you are going to delete the root element, so what you have to do? You have to remove the last node onto the root. Last node onto the root. So when you move the last node onto the root, what is done? You, in order to maintain the structure property, you are comparing the newly created root node with the next layer node 42. So accordingly, you need to do a swap if it is lesser. So once you do all the step downward, then the process is called reheapification downward. So that is the idea here. So that is what you need to do. So on this while summarizing the idea of heap, what is heap? Yeah, heap is a complete binary tree where entry at each node is greater than or equal to the entries in its children. To add an entry to a heap, place the new entry as the next available spot, and do the to remove a biggest entry, move the last node onto the root and perform a reheapification downward. So this is the step you should remember in order to do the heap property. So using heap tree, using this heap tree, you can construct a priority queue as well as you can do a shorting called a heap short. So these two things may it is not covered in your syllabus. Maybe in the next semester you will study a subject called design and analysis of algorithms. There you will study this idea, heap shot. So until now, just what you need is, what is mean by heap, what are the properties of heap, how to construct a heap, what is mean by reheapification upward, what is mean by reheapification downward, how to add an element and how to delete an element. While adding an element, what are the procedure you have to follow? While removing an element, what are the procedure you have to follow? So these are the things you should remember while you are studying the heap, right? So this class we have seen about two data structures. One is a threaded binary tree, another one is heap. So
okay, sir.
This I stop this presentation.